Welcome to the Identify instruction film. In this film, I'm going to take you through some highlights of the lesson and the game, so that you'll be later on able to conduct the game and the lesson yourself. What is Identify? Identify has a basic assumption, and that is that online information matters. Information that I share about myself and information that others share on me. All this information together build our online identity. The aim of Identify is to conduct dialogue with youngsters, both on information and on online identities. We believe that a dialogue is the most effective form to talk about these subjects, rather than moralizing, censoring, or filtering. We believe that by building a dialogue, we build trust. And with this trust, hopefully, when something goes really wrong, youngsters will come to us with their problems. The dialogue form is supported by a game. The game uses technology that is fairly modern, and it's called augmented reality. The game basically is an interactive questionnaire to which multiple choice answers are possible. The game represents dilemmas that we have online, dilemmas that we meet every day. The answers are given in the form of markers. Markers are printed out signs that we hold to our webcam so that the webcam can see them. The software then recognizes the markers and reacts to it by adding visual elements to the screen. These visual elements we call augmentations. All these augmentations together that we build up during the game build up our online identity, so that at the end of the game, we see what is normally our unseen, which is our online identity. But before we go to that, you first need to download a few files. Don't worry, the game is not about technology. The game is about your contact with the class. It's about your life experience and about your skills as a teacher that you share during the game. But of course, technology needs to work. Therefore, it's important to test out the game before you play it in the class. You should test it in your local environment and with the person you think that should play the game. You can find everything how to test it in the guide, the technical guide. Please read it. It's very important to create an atmosphere of trust in your class while playing the game. You could do that by spelling out some basic rules, like no gossiping afterwards, or If you don't want to talk, you don't have to talk. Or you don't laugh at another person. It's important that no one gets hurt and all feel safe to say what they have to say. It also is very important to involve each and every single individual in the class in the game. You could do that by asking them to read out aloud one of the questions. You could also invite them to share personal experiences with you. But again, if they don't want to, they don't have to. It's also important that you involve the whole class in a discussion. You could do that by voting afterwards, so that everybody feels that their voice has been heard. It's also very important that the person who's with you, sitting behind the camera, is involved in the whole process. The moment they lose concentration, the whole class loses concentration. So it's very important that they feel part of a team they build with you. You and the person behind the camera provide the game. Wat we gaan doen is, ik ga jullie vragen stellen, maar niemand hoeft te antwoorden. We gaan van voor een aantal regels bespreken. We gaan over gekke dingen hebben, of hele normale dingen, geen idee. Een van die regels is dat we elkaar niet uit gaan lachen. Het tweede is dat niemand hoeft te praten. Als iemand er geen zin in heeft, praat hij lekker niet. Als iemand wel zin heeft, praat hij lekker wel. Het derde is dat we de afloop, wat er ook gezegd is, gaan we niet overkoppelen. Als iemand iets geks vertelt, dan gaan we niet zeggen, nou, dat is wel stom. Als je wat te zeggen hebt, zeg je het nu of lekker niet.
Oké.
Ja, vinden we dat wat?
Ja.
Oké. Het idee is een beetje dat we het gevoel hebben vandaag dat we niet op school zitten nu op dit moment, maar dat we iets heel anders gaan doen. Wat we gaan doen is een spel, maar het is niet alleen maar een spel, het is ook een spel waarmee iets bedoeld wordt. De bedoeling is dat we gaan praten.
Thank you.
alles.
Nou, nee, maar...
Nee, ik zie heel veel nee.
Het was zo, mijn vader die zei ze dus gisteren zo, dus juist had gisteravond nog om 3:30 op Facebook of zo.
En hoe weet hij dat dan, denk je?
Geschiedenis?
Nou, nee, dan had hij even op mijn account geklikt, want hij volgt mij.
Oké.
Dat moet ik dus nog even gaan blokkeren.
En wat, wie is zijn vrienden met zijn eigen ouders op Facebook op huis?
Zal ik het doen?
Echt?
Helemaal niemand?
Mijn ouders hebben daar helemaal geen tijd voor.
We hebben geen tijd, gelukkig maar bij.
Ja, gelukkig wel, ja.
Want wie zou het leuk vinden om met zijn ouders op huis te zitten op Facebook?
Echt niet, je ziet ze toch?
Ja. Ja, maar zij kunnen ook zien wat jij doet. Is het fijn of is het helemaal
niet? Dat is niet helemaal niet fijn.
Zo, vind ik prima.
Ik snap het ook echt hier.
The lesson ends after 90 minutes, but the subject doesn't. In the later stage, you can always refer back to what you heard in the discussion, or you can always come back to what youngsters wrote down in questionnaires or put in their drawings. You could also give the URL of the game so the youngsters can play it themselves, and you can ask later on how it was and return to the subject. Also, do not be surprised if youngsters themselves return to the theme. We, from the Identify team, wish you an exciting journey.